Back at the build. Not really building much today, but I'm back at least. Okay. I didn't record a whole bunch of stuff, but well, some stuff. I actually been fiddling with the stereo. I got a new Pioneer deck here. It's got Bluetooth. It's got a USB port and an iPod connector there. And you can just play right out of the iPod's headphone jack. So there's three means of audio now, which is a lot better, more modern. It's even got a microphone. Microphone for the Bluetooth, so you can talk through your deck on your telephone, hands-free. Now, this is what was going on. When I first connected it, okay. I had troubles. I mean, decks are pretty easy to hook up. Ground, power, accessory power. So they have a constant power so that the systems, all your settings, your clock setting, all those kind of things, and your base setting that you set it at, it all remains in there because there's a faint voltage going to it. There's that one, and then you have accessory power so you can turn it into your accessories and she comes on. But I was having a problem like this. Yeah, the power's on. Going through my stuff here. Let's go for CD. See what happens. Oh, must be crowded in there. I'm touching here. Whoa, look at that. Now the freaking thing is working. But not very good. Oh, I see. It's just a thing. Oh, it's cutting out now. It's pretty shitty sounding. Yeah, there it goes. Okay, I couldn't even get it to play. That's the first. So somehow it's... Hey, as soon as power comes on, she shuts down. It's not enough voltage there to make it work. And my decks, see, are my amplifiers doing the same thing. They're trying to turn on. So, I scratched my head and I went through the whole thing. I mean, as these two units here have been sitting for 9 years, parked outside, you know, going through the seasons, there's humidity in the air and so forth. So I'm automatically, you think, well, let's check the power supply. So I always had it, I wouldn't call it Jippo, but I wasn't into it as much back then or whatever. I only went so far on this project. And I had a lot more connections going to the fuse box here. You have accessories. This friggin' light out of the way. Accessory ports up here that you can tie into. Now, there's
six success reports. I'm using three of them because I want them only to come on in an accessory position. I don't want it on all the time. And I put a bolt through the firewall here and, you know, sanded it all and made a good ground. Not in a bolt, so I can put all my grounds to this junction here. And I ran a main wire from the battery up to a terminal bus up here. Jesus. Next thing I should get is an LED light. This isn't quite as neat and tidy as I wanted it here. I might do that again. I guess it's out of the way. You see, you don't go in here. This is the terminal bus. Pop off the protective shield there. And it exposes all your connections. So this is hot, obviously, right from the battery. All these are hot, thus the protective shield, so you don't get a short. And I've run four wires so far over to a little fuse panel, auxiliary fuse panel, with the pop-in mini fuses on this one. It's a little bit smaller than these guys, but the same design. And I've got one in there for my stereo so far. There's going to be one for reverse lights, one for front auxiliary lights. You know, on it goes. There's six there. So I'm just going for the most major power consumers. Put them on a fuse so it's safer. And I've got a little sex light down here. It's a nice low light, and I could actually even try changing that with a LED bulb, but it's nice for driving at night. It just sort of illuminates the floor without being annoying for your driving. I like that. And I got a couple of LEDs I'm gonna put over in the far corners. They're brighter, and put them up high and have them shining down, and have them on a switch, which is gonna be here, this guy here, for those lights. And then I got that guy there for the sex light. I might move them around, make them side by side. And okay, so I worked on my power supply. I wanted to get all new wiring. I ran a new wire, nice big honking one from the battery. Shielded, it's all the way up to the battery, nicely tucked in and zap strapped and everything. And I got that all organized, and I wrote all the labels on them so I know what they are. And then I tried the stereo again, thinking, okay, well, that should fix it. Let's fire it up. So, as you know, that's what happens. She shuts down. And what I determined what it was a bad ground. Hey, it sounded shitty. All I need to do is cut the sparks. It was a bad ground. I
mainly because you don't have all the body panels on and all, you know, rubbing together, making a ground, because I'm grounding from the firewall, as you saw that ground union there with a nut and bolt. So it's relying on the firewall and the body to the frame connection, because this is another Gippo, which I had hooked up, which started the engine, actually. It's just a welding wire. It's half the size of what you're supposed to have, even more than less than what you need. But it started the engine, and see, it's grounded up here. So, it's only as good as what the engine is to the frame. And to the firewall, which it wasn't even connected. So that goes to the engine here, engine firewall. Actually, that's when I was in Taylor Motive. That was an issue more than once in certain problems. There was a bad strap there. They normally, with the heat, they normally break right there, the heat of the manifold. So that's all it was. Oh, bad ground, look at them go. Got my big honking 10-inch subwoofers. And these are house speakers, 8-ohm. And they fit in there just nicely. So that's my combo. These are going to be, okay, this is a smaller amp. Runs these ones here. I think these are like 200 watt, 8 ohms house speakers. They're really good energy. And I got the Explode Sonys here. Forget the wattage of those. Oh, 1700 watts. Woofers. I think I got the turn way down. Then I got my 5-inch up here in the corners. Pair of fours. And then that one over there. This one wasn't too bad. Minor cutting to make a 5 fit in there, because they're only designed for 4s from the factory. And this one was shoehorning it in for sure. I even had to file this away a little bit. It's still bonded to the cone there. It's okay, because of the when you put down the dash on there, it sticks it up a little bit. It rubbing on this cone here. Anyways, I cut this one out like crazy to make it work. Still gotta figure this all out. Oh yeah. custom cut. It's actually gonna make the seat one click from the longest setting, which is kind of a compromise there. I got long legs, and I would have liked to have gone all the way to the back, but what it is I didn't account for the speaker hitting the frame of the seat when I did my measurements. So I thought the speaker was going to be going to clear it, but it's actually, if I put a shim under the bottom of the speaker, it'll raise it up, and I do a little bit more sanding there, and I think it'll miss. But play around with it. Anyways, happy enough with it. This isn't a daily driver. You know, you go on a trip, and man, I don't think it matters. Because you're going camping. Anyways, got that all hooked up. Happy with that, it's all organized. Wiring, isn't a nice, the plastic shieldings went all the way along there. Let me tuck it under there a little bit better, but cool. And I got another one for the camper. Da-da-da. They're cheap. Walmart, $110 or something for this one. You know, that's outdated now. Time's gone by. I'd love to get back in this camper again. Okay. Yeah, I had an old Alpine in here, cassette deck, and it was wheezed. It wasn't working anymore. So I needed to get a deck. I mean, the amps were already here. They're all hooked up. Yeah, okay. Today, I'm going to assemble this one. Got it. Got all the pieces cut out. Oh yeah. It'll be death before dawn. Well, look, am I gonna work out? And it'll sound good in the bush, too. Cause I got mega cable. String it out on the trees. On heavy, heavy fuel. We got tunes again.